I'm so excited to be showing you my new hairstyle if you have not seen it already. I posted a photo of myself holding the hair that I cut off. Yes, I cut it off. I had put it up in a big ponytail at the salon, and my hairdresser told me that I could cut it off, so I cut it off myself. And then I donated it to Pantene Beautiful Lengths, and I was so proud of myself for doing that, and I absolutely love my new hair. So today I'm going to show you a few tricks and tips for styling your hair and taking care of your hair so that you can grow it out long and maybe even donate it yourself if you would like. Find at least one day in your week, at least, to just not wash your hair. Sounds gross, right? But really, I've been reading so many things about people not washing their hair, and it just feels so much healthier the next day when you actually wash it. I usually do it over the weekend if I can. Maybe I'm going to the beach or something, and I don't wash it, and I just give it a break because it's really good for your hair. It'll help it strengthen, and you just need to give your hair a break sometimes, too. If you're the type of person who has especially greasy hair or maybe oily hair that you need to wash it every day, that's fine. Maybe you can try an alternative by not using as much product in your hair. This is actually my natural hair now. My hair was somewhat wavy underneath before when it was longer, but I think because I got it cut off, it got a little curly. It's also a little humid out today, but this is my natural hair. I haven't put anything in it. And the past few days, I haven't really put anything in it just because I need to give my hair a break. And I like washing my hair because I like the clean feeling, but I do not wash it sometimes over the weekend. So once in a while, to avoid all the buildup of shampoo and conditioner in my hair, I take a little bit of Dawn dish soap in my hand, and I just wash my hair with the Dawn dish soap and just leave it in there for a minute. And once I rinse it out really good and make sure that it's all out, I just feel like I have cleaner hair. It's so weird because dish soap in your hair, but trust me, it works. If you want to try it, let me know how it works for you because it worked very great for me. A lot of you probably already know this tip, but I think it's very important when you're brushing your hair to just make sure that you're starting from the bottom and working your way up, because if you start up here and then you run into a knot, sometimes we just get angry and just rip your hair, and then we get the split ends, and then you gotta get a haircut and just brush your hair from the ends, and we'll all be good. So many of us use heat tools, but sometimes I like to put my heat tools away, especially because it's the summer and I'm going swimming, and what's the point of curling my hair or straightening my hair if it's just gonna get wet and go back to natural? So I am enjoying my natural hair right now and just letting whatever it wants to do happen. I really hope that you enjoyed these few tips and tricks that I shared with you today. I'm going to be giving you some more tips in the future, and I actually created a new tab on my blog just for tips and tricks, so I'll be uploading more to that. And so go check it out and check out my Instagram at wrapitup5 for more pictures and fun things that I will be doing in the summer. Bye, guys!